Solvete omnes. Today I'm going through the story of Io. Eamus ad scolam and audiamus de nymphis. Let's go to school and hear about the nymphs. Hodie est dies Iovis et septimum spatium, est tempus pro Latina prima classe. Today is Thursday and seventh period. It's time for the Latin 1 class. Discipuli et discipuli eun in conclave et sedent in cellis. The students go into the classroom and sit in chairs. Esne magister paratus docere? Is the teacher ready to teach? Sic, magister noa materium pro discipulis habet. Yes, the teacher has new material for the students. Sunt ne omnes discipuli parati discere? Minime, quid accidit? Are all the students ready to learn? No. What? What's happening? Multi discipuli sunt parati, sed tres discipuli cartam, penas, et libros non habent, et quinque sunt tardi. Many students are ready, but three students do not have paper, pens, and books, and five are late. Nunc omnes sunt in conclavi, et sunt parati. Now everyone's in the classroom and they are ready. In conclavi, tintinnabulum sonat. In the classroom, the bell rings. Magister, salvete discipuli. Hello, students. Discipuli et discipuli. Salve, magister. Hello, teacher. Magister, canamus exegi. Let's say exegi. Discipuli et discipuli, magister. Exegi monumentum aere perennius. I've built a monument more lasting than bronze. Magister, hodie docebo vos noa materium de nymphis. Estis ne parati discipuli? Today I'll teach you new material about the nymphs. Are you ready, students? Discipuli, certe, nos sumus parati. We are ready. Magister, Romani et Graeci narrant multas fabulas de nymphis. The Romans and Greek tell many stories about the nymphs. In mythologia, nymphae sunt creaturae divinae, sed non sunt immortales et non sunt mortales. In mythology, the nymphs are divine creatures, but they are not immortal and they're not mortal. Nymphae formas feminarum habet et vitas longas agunt. The nymphs have the shapes of women and live long lives. Nymphae sunt amicae deorum, sed in regia deorum non habitat. Nymphae in natura habitat. The nymphs are the friends of the gods, but they do not live in the palace of the gods. The nymphs live in nature. Placent nympha saltare, cantare, et ludere, et domus nympharis sunt silvae, montes, coles, campes, spelunci, flumina, et maria. Maria. The nymphs like to dance and sing and play, and the home of the nymphs are the forests, the mountains, the hills, the fields, the caves, rivers, and the seas. Flores, arbores, et animalia placent nymphis. Flowers, trees, and animals please the nymphs. Nymphae sunt non crudeles, sed nymphae sunt magnum periculum hominibus. The nymphs are not cruel, but the nymphs are a great danger to people. Si tu nymphae in media silva vides, dei possunt donare tibi magnas poenas. If you see a nymph in the middle of the woods, the gods can give you great punishment. Cur nemo scit, sed malum est dicere habitare et agere tempus cum nymphis. Why? No one knows, but it's bad to talk, to live, and to spend time with nymphs. Homines pro nymphas parva templet in natura faciebant. People used to make small temples for nymphs in nature. Sunt multi genera nympharum. There are many types of nymphs. Nymphae nomine dryades sunt nymphae arborum. The nymphs called the dryads are the nymphs of the trees. Dryades in silva habitant et vita dryades conjuncta est cum vita arboris. The dryads live in the forest, and the life of the dryad is joined with the life of a tree. Nymphae nomine oreads in sumis montes habitant, oreads sunt amicae Dianae. Nymphs named the oreads live on the top of mountains. The oreads are the friends of Diana. Nymphai nominate Naiades habitat in Fluminibus et Lacibus. The nymphs named the naiads live in rivers and in lakes. Naiads cum aquas dulcibus conjuncta sunt et naiads are joined with sweet water. And Discipuli nomine Maria magister tua materi est tam multa si placet nara nobis fabulam. Teacher, your material is too much, is so much. Please, if it pleases you, tell us a story. Magister Maria parque metu ecce fabulam de nympha. Maria, don't spare fear or don't worry. Here's a story about a nymph. Fabula de Io. Olim in antiqua Graeca erant herbs nominate Argos. Once in ancient Greece, there was a city named Argos. Erant ad urbem fluminum nomine Iacos. It was near a river named Iacos. Fluminum Iacos erant etiam deus et multas filias habet. The river Iacos was also a god and had many daughters. Filiae sunt nymphae naiades quod in dulcibus aquibus habitat. The daughters were nymphs, naiads, because they lived in fresh water. Iacos multas filias habet, sed optima fermissima et bellissima filia erat io. Iacos had many daughters, but the best, the strongest, and the most beautiful daughter was Io. Iorant nympha and amica omnia et placent ei narrare fabulas auscultare amicos saltare natare et donare auxilium. Io was a nymph and the friend of everyone. It pleased her to tell stories, to listen to her friends, to dance, to swim, and to give help. Semper erant flores in capite nymphae. There was always flowers on the head of the nymph. Nympha erant nunquam irrita et omnes nympha amat. The nymph was never angry, and everyone loved the nymph. Jupiter rex deorum, ionem, ex sumo monte Olympo, spectat, et nympha bellam amat, sed ira Ionis, regina deorum timuit. Jupiter, king of the gods, saw Io from the top of Mount Olympus, and loved the beautiful nymph. But the anger of Juno, queen of the gods, he feared. Nunc est die Saturni et mane est. Now it is Saturday and it is the morning. Io ex flumine exit et per media silva cum floribus incapite ambulat. Io leaves from the river and walks through the middle of the forest with flowers on her head. Eo volt spectare amicas dryades. Io wants to see her friends, the dryads. Dryades sunt nymphae qui arboribus habitat. Jupiter carpet diem et volat ex sumo Olympo. The dryads are nymphs who live in the trees. Jupiter seizes the day and flies down from the top of Olympus. Jupiter. Salve, Io, dulces flores, nympha. Hello, Io, sweet flowers, nymph. Io, salve, quis es? Hello, who are you? Jupiter, ego sum optimus maximus deus rex deorum, Jupiter, ut vales? I am the best and the greatest god, king of the gods, Jupiter. Ut vales, how are you? Non male, sed cur tu non es in sumo monte Olympo? Not bad, but why are you not on the top of Mount Olympus? Jupiter, ego sum in silva tecum, quod tu es bellissima et te amo. I am in the forest with you because you are the most beautiful and I love you. Io. Ego sum tam laeta et o rex deorum, te amo. I am so happy and o rex deorum, I love you. Nube sunt in caelo et sol non lucet. Now there are clouds in the sky and the sun does not shine. Juno regia deorum temptat in venere regem deorum, sed Jupiter est in terra cum nympha. Juno, queen of the gods, tries to find the king of the gods, but Jupiter is on the earth with the nymph. Juno spectat et sumo monte Olympo et nubes in Graecia Weedet. Juno looks from the top of Mount Olympus and sees clouds in Greece. Juno cogitat, non est humidum en Graecia, est caldissimum, cur nube sunt ibi, quid agit Jupiter? Juno thinks, it is not humid in Greece. It is very warm. Why are there clouds there? What is Jupiter doing? Juno irrita ex monte Olympo volat it ad Graeciam. The angry Juno flies from Mount Olympus and goes to Greece. Jupiter et Io nympha audiunt reginam deorum et Jupiter scit iram. Jupiter and Io, the nymph, hear the queen of the gods, and Jupiter knows the anger. Deus consilium habet. He has a plan. Mutabit forma nympha. Juno non nympha sed vacuum spectabit, Jupiter cogitat. He will change the form of the nymph. Juno will not see a nymph, but will see a cow, Jupiter thinks. Ubi Juno per nubes ad silvam volt et iovem regem deorum invenit. Dea non nympha sed vacuum spectat. When Juno flies to the clouds, to the forest, and finds Jupiter, king of the gods, the goddess does not see a nymph, but sees a cow. Juno non stulta est. Juno is not stupid. Juno, sale rex deorum et me frater, quid agis? Juno, hello, king of the gods and my brother. How are you doing? Jupiter, bene, et tu? Juno, dum spiro spero, quid facis? Juno, while I breathe, I hope. What are you doing? Jupiter, ambulo per silum et specto arbores et aves et walk. I'm walking through the forest and looking at the trees and the birds and the cat. Juno, pull! Quid facas cum waca? By Pollux, what are you doing with the cow? Jupiter, Hercule, meus amicus mihi vacuum donavit. By Hercules, my friend gave the cow to me. Juno, optime, amo vacas. Meum animal es vaca et heri erat meus dies natalis. Very good. I love cows. My animal is a cow, and yesterday was my birthday. Donabisne mihi vacuum, will you give me a cow? Si me amas, donabis mihi vacuum. If you love me, you will give me the cow. Juno est victrix et miser Jupiter deam vacuum donat. Juno is the winner, and the miserable Jupiter gives the cow to the goddess. Sine mora Jupiter volat ad montem Olympum. Without delay, Jupiter flies to Mount Olympus. Nunc Juno vacuum habet. Now Juno has the cow. Quid dea faciet? What will the goddess do? Juno bono consilium habet. Vacuum argo donabo et argus vacuum servabit. Juno has a good plan. I will give the cow to Argus, and Argus will guard the cow. Jupiter erit tam miser. Jupiter will be so sad. Quid est Argus? Argus est horribilis gigas et Argo sunt centum oculi incapite. Who is Argus? Argus is a horrible giant, and Argus has 100 eyes on his head. Argus nunquam dormit et est optimus custos in mundo. Argus never sleeps and is the best guard in the world. Juno jubet argum servare vacuum. Juno orders Argus to guard the cow. Nunc Argus vacuum bene servat. Now Argus guards the cow well. Quotidie Argus vacuum per campos agit. Daily the Argus drives the cow through the fields. Ibem misera vaca, olim nympha, urbas mordit, et num aquam exclumine bibit. There the miserable cow, once a nymph, eats grass and drinks water from the river. Ubi sol lucet et dies escalidus, Io, or Io, nunc vacat et Argus sub arboribus sedet et Argus flores in summa capita ponet. When the sun shines and the day is hot, Io, now a cow, and Argus under the trees sit, and Argus places flowers on the top of her head. Argus etiam fabulas nymphae narrat. Argus also tells stories to the nymph. Uno die in campis eo patrem et sororibus nympha spectat et ad patrem ambulat et temptat loqui. One day in the fields, Io sees her father and sister nymphs, and she walks to her dad and tries to talk. Quod nympha est vaca, eo non loquitur, sed mugit. Because the nymph is a cow, Io does not speak, but she moos. Tandem Io, Io, scribit, nomen in terra. Finally, Io writes her name on the ground. Pater et sorores lacrimat et vaca lacrimat. The father and the sisters cry, and the cow cries. Pater, o Hercle, o misera Io, quid accidit? Why Hercules, o miserable Io, what has happened? Quis te in vaca mutat, who changed you into a cow? Cur Argus servat te, why is Argus guarding you? Io, mugio, I moo. Pater, amamus te, cur exis, spectabimus te iterum? We love you. Why are you leaving? Will we see you again? Io, mugio. Tandem Argus vacam domum agit et io ex familia debent exire. Finally, Argus drives the cow home, and Io has to leave from her family. Jupiter est miser et nunc consilium habet. Jupiter is miserable and now has a plan. Jupiter iubet mercurium nuntium deorum et psycho pompum volare ex sumo monto Olympa et servare miseram nymphum. Jupiter orders Mercury, the messenger of the gods and the psycho pompus, to fly from the top of Mount Olympus and to save the miserable nymph. Mercurius caduciam calceos penatos et pestasum penatum et gladium capit et volat ad terram. Mercurius grabs the caduceus, his winged sandals and his winged hat and his sword and flies to the earth. Nunc Mercurius est in terra. Now Mercury is on the earth. Mercurius argum cum multos oculos videt et argus mercurium videt. Mercurius sees Argus with his many eyes, and Argus sees Mercury. Mercurius, salve Arge. Hello, Argus. Argus, salve Mercury. Dulces calcei. Hello, Mercury. Sweet sandals. Mercurius, gratias. Dulces oculi. Quid novi? Thanks. Sweet eyes. What's new? Argus, non multum ego vacam specto et servo. Not much. I'm watching the cow and guarding it. Mercurius. Oh, ego tibi novas fabulas habio. Oh, I have new stories for you. Argus. Optime. Narra mihi tuas fabulas. Excellent. Or very good. Tell me your stories. Mercurius narrat argo fabulam et tum alternam fabulam et tum multas alias. Mercurius tells Argo a story and then another story and then many more. Many other stories. Sol lucet et calidum est et Argus est fessus. The sun is shining and it's hot and Argus is tired. Mercurius loquitur et loquitur et loquitur. Mercurius talks and talks and talks. Argus centum oculis habet, sed mox duo oculi dormiunt. Argus has 100 eyes, but soon 2 eyes are sleeping. Tum quator oculi dormiunt, et tum decem alii oculi dormiunt. Then 4 eyes are sleeping, and then 10 other eyes are sleeping. Mox omnes oculi dormiunt, tum Mercurius claudium capit et necat argum. Ooh. Soon all the eyes are sleepy. Then Mercury grabs his sword and kills Argus. Oof. Postquam Mercurius argum gigantem cum centum oculis necavit, Mercurius vacuum liberavit, sed vacuum in nymphom non mutavit, quod scientium non habet. Afterwards, after Mercury killed Argus, a giant with 100 eyes, Mercurius freed the cow, but he did not change the cow into a nymph because he does not have the knowledge. Mercurius. Salve, Io. Dulcia cornua. Hello, Io. Sweet horns. Io. Mugio. Mercurius. Tu es libre. Exi ex e domum. You are free. Go. Leave and go home. Mugio. Mercurius. Ego scio te ad hunc esse vacuum. I know that you are still a cow. Nota bene, Mercurius potus dicere cum animalibus. Note well, Mercury can talk with animals. Mugio. Mercurius. Volo te non possum mutare te in nymphom. I want, but I can't change you into a nymph. Non habeo scientiam. I don't have the knowledge. Io. Mugio. Mercurius. Ignosce mihi. Fortate Jupiter potest mutare te in nymphom. Forgive me. Perhaps Jupiter can change you into a nymph. Io. Mugio. Mercurius. Volo narrare tibi, sed nescio ubi Jupiter sit. I want to tell you, but I don't know where Jupiter is. Harry ego spectave Iovem in Monte Olimpo. Yesterday I saw Jupiter on Mount Olympus. Io. Mugio. Curious. Ignosce mihi. Debio exire et volare ad montem Olympum. Vale. Forgive me. I have to go and fly to Mount Olympus. Bye. Mugio. Mercurius volavit ad montem Olympum et eo ad hunc vacuum domum ivit. Mercurius flies to Mount Olympus, flew to Mount Olympus, and Io, still a cow, went home. Domi Io vult narrare fabulum patri et soribus, sed Io non potest loquere quod est vaca. At home, Io wants to tell a story to her father and her sisters, but Io cannot speak because she is a cow. Omnes sunt tristes. Everyone are sad. Everyone is sad. Juno mocks audit Argum est mortuum et nymphom esse liberum. Juno soon hears that Argus is dead and the nymph is free. De est tristis quod Argus est mortuus et est tam irrita quod io est libera. The goddess is sad because Argus is dead and is so angry because Io is free. Magna dea scit quid acciderit et noam consiliam capit. The great goddess knows what has happened and seizes a new plan. Juno novas poenas nympha donabit. Juno will give new punishments to the nymph. Primo autem Juno oculos es argo capit et oculos in cauda pavonis ponit. First, however, Juno grabs the eyes from Argus and places the eyes in the tail of a peacock. Etiam nunc pavones ad hunc oculos in cauda habet. Even now, peacocks still have eyes in their tail, or on their tail. Nunc Juno regia deora magnus poenas nymphae donabit. Now Juno, queen of the gods, will give great punishments to the nymph. Juno asylum horribilem ad vaca mittit. Juno sends a horrible gadfly to the cow. Silus vacuum olim nymphom domi invenit. The gadfly finds the cow, once a nymph, at home. Asylus horribus mordit et mordit et mordit. The horrible gadfly bites and bites and bites. Io est libera, sed est tam tristis. Io is free, but she is so sad. Io ad hunc vacuum lacrimat et domo exit. Io, still a cow, cries and leaves home. Io per multas terras erat, sed asylus horribus semper mordet. Io wanders through many lands, and the horrible gadfly always bites. Io ad hunc vacuum trans aegaeum mare natat, sed horribilis asylus perpetuus mordet. Io, still a cow, swims across the Aegean Sea, but the horrible gadfly perpetually bites. Io ad hun quacat ad urbem Troiam, it et Troianus homines spectat sed Asilus semper mordet. Io, still a cow, goes to the city of Troy and looks at the Trojan people, but the gadfly always bites. Io ad hunc vacam, montem Etna ascendit, sed Asilus vacam invenit, et perpetuus mordet. Io, still a cow, climbs Mount Etna, but the gadfly finds the cow and constantly bites. Io ad hunc vacam etiam ad urbem Babylonem, it et magna templa antiquorum deorum et dua flumine magna alterum nomine Tigris et alterum nomine Euphrates spectat, sed Asilus mordet et mordet et mordet. Io, still a cow, also goes to the city of Babylon and sees the great temples of the ancient gods and the two great rivers, one named the Tigris and the other named the Euphrates. But the gadfly bites and bites and bites. Io ad hunc vacam per multas terras et super colles et montes erant et multam spectant sed non potes fugere ex asilo. Io, still a cow, wanders through many lands and over hills and mountains and sees much, but she is not able to escape the gadfly. Misera vaca, poena magna es. Miserable cow, great is the punishment. Tanem Io ad montes nomine Caucasus venit et Prometheum ibi invenit. Finally, Io comes to the mountains named the Caucasus and finds Prometheus there. Nota bene, Prometheus est Titanus et magna sapientium habet. Note well, Prometheus the Titan has great wisdom. In Titomachia, Prometheus auxilium deis donavit. In the Tantamachia, Prometheus gave help to the gods. Postea Prometheus homines creavit et docuit homines agriculturam, mathematicam, anicinam, navigare, scribere, curare animalia et multa alia. Afterwards, Prometheus created people and taught people agriculture, math, medicine, how to sail, how to write, how to take care of animals, and many other things. Quod etiam Prometheus ignem ex Caelo rapuit et donavit ignem hominibus, Jupiter magnus poenas Titano donavit. Because also Prometheus stole fire from the sky and gave fire to people, Jupiter gave great punishments to the Titan. Nunc Prometheus vinculis a perpetuum in sumo monte manet magnus avis aquila iacur omnes dies edit. Now Prometheus in chains forever on the top of the mountain stays, and a great bird, in some versions I have put down here a vulture, but here is an aquila, a great bird, an eagle, eats his liver every day. Est mane et dies jovis. Is in the morning, and it's Thursday. Temperatura est frigida, quote, Io et Prometheus in sumo monte est. The temperature is cold because Io and Prometheus are on top of a mountain. Prometheus, salve, Io. Hello, Io. Io, mugio. Prometheus, parce metu, nolle est tristis. Nota bene, Prometheus potest dicere cum animalibus. Don't worry. Don't be sad. Note well, Prometheus can talk with animals. Io, mugio. Prometheus, ego multa sapientium et multam scientium habeo, etiam scio futurum. I have much wisdom, and I know, and I have, and much knowledge. Also, I know the future. Mugio. Prometheus, exi et montibus et e ad terram aegyptum. Leave from the mountains and go to the land of Egypt. Ibi Jupiter te servabit, mutabit tuam formam in formam humanum. There Jupiter will save you. He will change your form into the form of a human. Tu non eris vacuam, tu eris iterum nympha. You will not be a cow, you again will be a nymph. Ibi in Aegypto tu filium nomine Epaphus habebis, et in magno templo habitabitis. Omnes homines te amabunt, sed tuas filius non bene in scola faciant. There in Egypt you will have a son named Epaphus, and in a great temple you will live. All the people will love you, but your son will not do well in school. Mugio! Percolate, ego scio, o tempora o amores. By Hercules, I know. O the times, o the character. Io. Mugio! Prometheus, tuus filius filium habebit, et tuum filius filium habebit, et una die mater filium nomine Perseus habebit. Your son will have a son, and then the son will have a son, and then one day a mother will have a son named Perseus. Perseus erit magnus vir et magnus res faciet. Io, ubi tu es? Perseus will be a great man and will do great things. Io, where are you? Silus nunc vaca mordet et io tristis ex sumo monte fugit. The gadfly now bites the cow, and Io, the sad Io, leaves from the top of the mountain. Io adhunc vacam per multas terras erant et tandem ad Aegyptum venit. Io, still a cow, wanders through many lands, and finally she comes to the land of Egypt. Ibi omnia quae Prometheus narrat accidarunt. Everything which Prometheus said happened. Jupiter mutat vacam in forma humanum et io filium nomine Epaphus habet. Jupiter changes the cow into the form of a human, and Io has a son named Epaphus. Io et Epaphus in magno temple habitat, et Epaphus multos amicos in scola habet. Io and Epaphus live in a great temple, and Epaphus has many friends in school. Epaphus habet amicum nomine Phaethon. Epaphus has a friend named Phaethon. Venus. The end. Valete omnes lingua latina est vita.